Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to our class on assignment problem. This is our second session, and we'll continue further solving problems related to assignment problem. So when we talk about assignment problem, we solve the given problem by using Hungarian approach. So you can see here, like there's a company is there. It have five jobs and it have five machines. So five jobs, it have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and it have five machines. Okay, A, B, C, D, E. Okay, so any job can be done on any machine. Okay, and you know that one job will be done on one machine, and one machine can do one job. So it's not like one machine can do more than one job. So one job can be given to one machine. Okay, and the overall objective is to minimize the total cost, because the element what is given in the matrix, they are basically the cost parameter, the cost matrix. So if here is given 13 unit. A11, job 1, machine A, that is 30 units. Means that if you want to do the job 1 from machine A, you need to incur 13 unit of the money. Similarly, if job 1, machine B is given 8, that means in order to do the job 1 from machine B, you need to incur 8 unit of money. So I hope you understood this. Now, what approach we do to solve the problem? We solve the problem by using Hungarian approach. So what we do basically in Hungarian approach, we find the row in the row wise, we find the minimum element in the row. Okay, we find the minimum element in the row. You can see this. So I will find the minimum element in the row. We'll find the minimum element in the row. So row wise, every row, I'll find the minimum element in the row. Then what I'll do, I'll subtract this minima, the minimal element of the row, from all other element of the row. Okay, I'll do this job. So I'll do this job where I'm subtracting the minimal element of the row. So I'll do this job where I'll subtract the minimum element of this row. Okay, so I'll subtract that value from all other values from this. Okay, so 13 minus 8. So if I do this, 13 minus 8 is 5. Okay, then 8 minus 8 is 0. Then 16 minus 8 is 8. Okay, and then 18 minus 8 is 10. And then 19 minus 8 is 11. Clear? And then similarly, this second row, this I have done 9 minus 9, 0, 15 minus 9, 6, then 24 minus 9 would be 15, 9 minus 9, 0, and 12 minus 9, 3. And then 12 minus 4 is 8, then 9 minus 4 is 5, 4 minus 4 is 0, 0, 0. Then 0, 6 minus 6 is 0, 12 minus 6 is 6, 10 minus 6 is 4, and 8 minus 6 is 2, and 13 minus 6 is 7. Then 15 minus 12 is 3, then 17 minus 12 is 5, then 18 minus 12 is 6, 12 minus 12 is 0, and 20 minus 12 is 8. Clear, everyone? So we found the minimum element in the row, and that we subtract that minimum element from all other elements of the row, and we get the matrix. The way what we did, so this homework row wise, now we can do the same homework column wise. If you see column wise, every column has one zero. So then you can understand there will be no change. There will be no change. You can understand this part, because we found the minimum element in the row. We found the minimum element in the row, and we subtracted all other element of the row from that minimum element. We did that job row wise. Now, if I do this work column wise, here is that every column has one zero. So because of that reason, there will be no change column wise. So if I find the minimum element in each column, that is zero, and then we subtract all the element by the minimum element. So you can understand, use your under basic understanding of maths, you can say that there will not be any change. Clear everyone? Then, so once you did this homework row wise, followed by column wise, now what you need to do, we'll do allocation. Okay, we'll do allocation of work. Okay, row wise, column wise, we'll do allocation. So that allocation, what we'll do, that allocation will do keeping zero into consideration. Okay. So this allocation, this finding the row minima, okay, every row, then finding the column maxima, column minima, every column, and subtracting all the element of row and column from that column minima. What was the overall objective, guys, if you can understand? If you use your basic understanding, we are trying to minimize the cost. So we are trying to find out that value, which is the minimal value, so that overall our cost can be minimized. So that is that approach we are using to solve the problem. So if you just look into row wise and column wise and see that rows or that column which has only one zero and do allocation on that. So if you see column row one, it has one zero. So you can do allocation. Okay, row two has two zero, don't do allocation. Row three has three zero, don't do allocation. Row four has one zero, you can do allocation and cancel the zero if you have in that corresponding row or column. Then our last row has one zero, you can do allocation, cancel the zeros. Okay, so we did this row wise. Now if I look into column wise, column third has one zero, so I can do allocation. Then so once you look into this, once you have done the allocation row wise, if you noticed, the second row is not at all allocated. Okay, so you can understand the second row is not at all allocated. So whichever row is not at all allocated, you have to make sure that every row is being allocated. But if you see the second row is not allocated, so what you do, tick that row which is not allocated. Now in that row, see where zeros are there, tick the corresponding column. Wherever you find zero, pick the corresponding column. Wherever you find the zero, is this done? Clear everyone? So first tick that row which is not allocated. In that row, see where zeros are there, tick the corresponding column for that. Okay, now within that column, suppose column one, so wherever zero is allocated, just tick that zero. So here zero is allocated, tick it. Here zero is allocated, tick it. Now what you have to do, once you are done with this job, what you do, make a cross over the ticked column, make a cross over the ticked column, and make a cross over the unticked row. So make a cross over the ticked column and make a cross over the unticked row. Then Once you've done this, now look at those values which are not allocated. Now look at those values which is not crossed, means no line, either single or double line has actually went above them. Look at those values. I hope you can see them very easily. You can recognize them. In case of doubt, I'm just coloring them in case you should not get confused. Clear? Clear, right? So these 6, 15, 3, 6, 4, 7, 5, 6, 8 are those elements which are not at all crossed, either by single line or either by double line. So out of these elements, find the element which is having the minimum value. That element we call as theta. So the theta here is 3. The element which is having the minimum value is, we call that is theta. Okay. So once you get that minimum element as a theta, now what you have to do, see those elements which is crossed twice. Okay, see those elements which is being crossed twice, like see this element which is I'm coloring right now. Can you see this, right? These two lines bisected. Okay, you can see this element. Okay, you can see this element which is crossed by two lines. Okay, you can see this. Okay, now what you do, whichever element I just highlighted with this blue color marker, so you can understand what you need to do on those elements, you have to add theta. Okay, if it crossed by two lines, you have to add theta. And those elements which is crossed by single line, which is crossed by single line, what are those single lines? Just all these values, those elements which are crossed by single line, you can see them, this. Single line, this is single line, these are single line, which is crossed by single line. You can see them, they are crossed by single line. You can see them, they are crossed by single line. You can see them, they are crossed by single line. Okay, so what we'll do, do not touch them. They keep their values as it is what they are there. Clear, everyone? And those elements which are not at all crossed, subtract theta from all of them. Understood, right? So we have three kinds of element right now. One element in one kind of elements are there, okay, which is crossed, which is bisected. Okay. So what you do, whatever is the old element, add theta to them. Okay. Now second kind of elements which are crossed by one line. They are crossed by one line, either horizontal or vertical. Okay, simply crossed. So over them, there's one line went away. So do not touch them. Do not change their values. Do not change their values. And third kind of elements are there. Third kind of elements are there over which no line. Third kind of element over which there is no line. Okay, so subtract theta from them, whatever is the value, subtract theta from them. This is 8, this is 0, this is 8, this is 13, this is 11, this is 0, this is 3, this is 12, then this is 0, then this is 0. Then this is 11, then this is 5, then 0, then this is 3. Then 0, then this is 0, then this is 3, 1, 2, 4, then 3, then 2, then 3, then 0, then 5. Clear, everyone? So once I've done this, now I look into that row. We have only one element is there. Only one zero is there, sorry, I'm telling one element. So I'll do allocation. Second row I'll not touch. Third row I'll not touch. Fourth row, only one zero, I can do allocation. Fifth row, 10, I can do allocation. Okay, first column nothing, second column nothing, third column 10, I can do allocation. All done. क्लियर एवरीवन? Understood, right, everyone? Anyone have any doubt? So once you get this final allocation, now just see, just write down your original data. Write down your original data. So your original data was, you had five jobs and you had five machine. So you had five jobs. You have job five jobs. And you have five machines. A, your original data. A, B, C, D, E, clear? So you can see the first job. So this second job you can see here. Third job is here. Fourth job is here. Fifth job is here. Got it, right? So you can see this way I do the allocation of jobs. Okay, this way I'll do the allocation of jobs over the different machines. Okay, and this would be the best way where the cost can be minimized. So you can find your total cost. So your optimal cost. So that would be 08, 12, 04, 06, 12. This is 10 plus 24. 10 plus 24 is 34 plus 8. 34 plus 8 is 42 rupees. That is your optimal cost. Clear, everyone? Anyone any doubt? So your optimal cost is 42 rupees. Any doubt, anyone? Thank you. Any doubt, anyone? Now, suppose if you get an unbalanced assignment problem, how will you do that? Suppose if there's a question is like this, a company has 4 machines, a company has 4 machines to do 3 jobs. A company has 4 machines to do 3 jobs. Job, each job can be assigned. Each job can be assigned to only 1 machine. You can understand 1 machine will remain empty without any work at the end of the day. So the cost of each job on each machine is given below. Cost of each job on each machine, the cost of each job on each machine is given below. Okay, so determine the job assignment that will minimize the cost. Determine the job assignment, determine the job assignments, determine the job assignments that will minimize the total cost. Clear, everyone? So this is basically, if you understand, this is basically the case of, this is basically the case of unbalanced assignment problem. This is basically the case of unbalanced assignment problem. So now you can see this, machines W, X, Y, Z, 18, 8, 10, then 24, 13, 13, 13, 15. So there are four machine W, X, Y, Z, and 3 jobs are there. A, B, and C. They are the value of jobs. 4 machines, 3 jobs. How will you do that? So guys, always remember, whenever we are solving assignment problem, we need to make sure that the objective function should always be minimization of total cost. So here the objective function is the minimization of total cost. So here the element which is given in the matrix are basically their cost matrix. Okay, the next thing what you can do, next thing it is very important that the matrix what we see, it should be square matrix. So in case if we do not find the square matrix, so what we can do, we can make it a square, temporary square, dummy values, by adding dummy values. So by adding dummy values here. So I added a dummy. Okay. So now you can see you have 4 rows and 4 columns. So what I did, I added dummy row. So I added dummy rows to make sure that I have a total number of rows equal to the total number of column. Clear, everyone? Clear. Now, once you're done with that part, you added a dummy row to make sure the total row equal to total column. Now, find the smallest element in every row. Find the smallest element in every row and then subtract all the element of the row from the smallest element. Okay, so this is 0, this is 6, this is 10, and this is 14. Then this is 0. This is 5, then this is 9, and then this is 10. Then this is 0, this is 5, this is 9, this is 12. This is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. So then you can see row wise and column wise also. Every column also there is a 1, 0 already there. So identifying the minimum element in column and then subtracting all the element from that does not work here. Okay, so I can start doing the allocation here. So just focus on the first cell. Just focused on the first cell. So the first row. So first row is 1, 0. So you can do allocation here. Then second row, no 0, nothing. Third row, no 0. Fourth row, there are 4 zeros. I cannot tell them. Second column has 1, 0. So you can do allocation. Cancel the unallocated zeros. Now you can see there's no 0 left. So I cannot do any allocation for second row and third row. So tick them, then go there and see where zeros are there. So they have 0 only in first column. And there in first column, the first element is being allocated. So tick the corresponding row for that. Okay, now what you do, make a line over ticked column and unticked row. And then find the theta. Theta, which is the smallest element of unallocated, uncrossed cell, that is 5. So your theta, if your theta is 5, then the matrix will become, this is 0, this is 0, then the theta is 5, your theta is 5, 6 minus 5, 1, 10 minus 5, 1, 14 minus 5, 9, this is 0, this is 0, and then 0 plus 5, 5, then 0, 0, 4, 4, 5, then 7, then 0, then 0, then 0. Now if you see, you can allocate, you can do allocation, you can do allocation on the first row, second row, third row, fourth row, you cannot touch, second column, first column, you cannot touch, third column, 1, 0. Now, if you see this, now you have a second row and third row where 1, 0 is allocated, 1, 0 is there. If I do allocation here, this will get cancelled. Now, out of all the rows which is not allocated, third row is not allocated, I'll tick that row. Now, in that row, if there's a 0, I'll tick the corresponding column for that. Okay, now within that column, is there any element allocated? Yeah, second row, second element. So tick the corresponding row for that. Tick the corresponding row for that. Now what I have to do, cross the column which is being allocated, cross the column which is allocated, cross the column which is allocated, cross the column which is being allocated. Cross the column which is allocated and cross the row which is not allocated. Now what you will do, then find the theta. Theta is 4. Theta is 4. So this will be 0, 1, 1, 4, 5 minus 4. 9 minus 4, 5. Then 0, 0, 0, 1. Then 0, 0. Then 0, then 3. Then 8, no. 2 line cross. 5 plus 4, no. 9. 9, then 4. Then 0, then 0. First row, we can do allocation. First row, we can do allocation. Second row, third row, we cannot touch. Like this way, if you see, this have 1, 0, it's not being allocated. Now you can see. Now, whenever you get this kind of situation, you can understand this. This will create two answers. Now, if you have 4 zeros like this, if you get 4 zeros like this, then this will create two scenario. This will, if you get this kind of scenario, this will give you two answer. So how will get that? This I can do like this. 0, 1, 1, 5, 0, 0, 9. Then 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 3, 4, 0, 0. This is 0, 1, 1, 5, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 3, 9, 4, 0, 0. Okay, when you get this scenario, now if you talk about allocation, this is allocated, this is allocated. Now, if you get this situation, guys, now two possibilities are there for your answer. So what are those possibilities, sir? One possibility can be this and this allocation. And the another possibility will be this and this allocation. I hope you understood this. This will create two possibilities. So both of them can be answered. Done, everyone. So once you get that, so here for this problem, I have two possibilities. So if I write down my original data, so I had 4, 18, 8, 10, 0, 24, 13. Then 28, 17, 19, 0. Then 32, 18, 22, 0. Okay, and then this is 18, 8, 10, 0. Then 24, 13, 0, then 28, 20, 19, 0, then 32, 18, 22, 0. If I talk about allocation, guys, so this is being allocated, this is one possibility, this and this. Okay, so you can see this possibility, guys. So this, so here you have A, B, C, D. You had 4 machines, right? You have 3 jobs and you have 4 machines, right? W, X, Y, Z. So you had 4 machines. W, X, Y, Z. So which job is, which machine will not work, guys? Machine Z. W, X, Y, Z. And you have 4. and you have three jobs A, B, and C. Ito is a dummy job. You can understand this. I can find the cost. Which job does not get, which machine does not get the job? Machine D. Total cost here and here. This is 18 plus 13 plus 19. Here this is 18 plus 15 plus 17. So 7 plus 5, 12. 12 plus 8, 20. 2 carry. 2, 3, 4, 5. 50 rupees. This is 12, 20. This is also 50. Clear everyone? Fine, guys. Clear. We'll do this much in today's class. Any doubt, anyone? Thank you all, everyone. I'll see you all tomorrow.